in over the last weeks. So I can't see very well yet, but should we start with some questions? We're just thinking, just any reactions that you had to the performance tonight. I mean, really, it's completely free, whatever you would like to say, comments, questions on the performance, questions to the students involved, what it's like being part of the project. Obviously, Hannah's here as well, if you have any more questions about the actual research that's behind the script, how it was all put together, it's all completely open, and yeah, the students also, they might have some questions for you afterwards.
Anybody like to start? Yes, please.
Okay, so in acting, how did the students feel about being an immigrant, and has that changed your attitude towards immigrants in Coventry?
We've all had these conversations. I know they will have something to say, so
please be brave. Okay, so it was like, obviously it was a serious role to play because it is a big issue everywhere. And I don't think we kind of understood it as much as we did before.
How did it make you feel? If you'd been an immigrant, how did it make you feel acting it?
It's not recognised as a problem as much as it should be. And I don't think that, unless you've heard what people have said that have been in that situation, I don't think you fully understand it. I don't think even we don't fully understand it, even though we've been acting as it, but it kind of makes you empathize with them.
Anybody else like to say something? What was it like to act somebody that wasn't you, that was a completely different kind of life experience to what you know, maybe normally? Yeah?
Well, the first session you did with it, and you spoke about what an immigrant was, I didn't even know what it was, and I didn't even understand it. It was like this big of an issue, and like some of the stuff that was said in there was actually like really upsetting, because those are actually people's opinions on what actually happened about it, and that was really upsetting.
Any more?
Will it make you feel different towards immigration, people that have immigrated over here, and you see them out on the streets? Yeah.
Yeah.
And who do you think is going to do the most to help them? Us or the government?
Well, I think the whole point of the production, it was to show how, in a way, what the news, in a way, hides away. Because if you think about what you see on the news, even though it seems like a big thing, you're only getting like a little slice of what's happening, a little glaze of what's happening to the situation. And I think the whole point was to make people realise that what's happening on the news is, well, it's literally only telling you a minor thing, a minor view, not what the people think who are affected by this, but what is viewed on, or like stereotypically viewed on.
Yeah, so that's very interesting. So would you approach news and information quite differently now, or when you kind of presented with stories, newspapers, how has that changed? What do you kind of think now, whereas compared to before doing this project?
Before, I used to always say that news told the truth and that there was nothing else behind it. But now that I've done this play, I've actually seen that there's more to it than just what the news says. Like there's always like a hidden bit that people won't say about, or they'll just keep quiet because they're keeping it hidden from the public.
So there's like lots of different kind of voices that are all bound up just in one story often, but they're not necessarily always the main one. Great.
From a research point of view, has the research been done globally? It feels like a very British problem, but is this something that's happening worldwide? Is there a global need for migration, or is this, are you looking further afield than just us? Because obviously we only see it from a British point of view, what the media tells us in this country.
Yeah, I mean, it is a global issue. This research project was just in the UK, so we did focus groups in Coventry and Birmingham, in two parts of London, in Cardiff and in Glasgow and in Bradford. So we tried to get around Britain, and we did a kind of national survey as well, but we just focused on what the British government was doing because of the size of the project. But it's definitely something that's happening. Migration is happening around the world, and the kind of toughness about migration and the kind of governments trying to control and manage migration is also happening in different ways in different countries.
Your focus is always on the negatives, isn't it? It must be a very, very tiny part, the negative aspects of migration is essential, you know, for work and philosophy, but it seems that the media focus is always on the negative aspects of it.
Yeah, I mean, it often is, and this was the government kind of specifically putting out messages about controlling, and they were talking about controlling illegal immigration, but we wanted to see how that was affecting people more generally to think about migration, and it was in negative ways. So some people who felt targeted, like you heard, and some people who felt worried about migration and wanted to be controlled weren't necessarily reassured either by this kind of stuff. So that's what our research found, but obviously it's a massive subject, like you say.
What percentage of are illegal immigrants in the country at the moment?
That's a really hard... the numbers, you can't know who's... And the word illegal is difficult because the thing is that the law changes around people as well. So if you think about... If you heard of the Windrush scandal last year, so that was people who had come to Britain legally, but the laws changed and the records changed, so they were then designated as not having the right papers.
So those that are sneaking across the borders
and
is illegal rather than coming over here and then becoming... illegal because of a law change.
The thing is that can happen to people as well. So you can be here on a visa and overstay. That's a large number of people who are... So we don't have the figures here, but in Australia they have figures on who's come in and out. And the third largest group of irregular or non... I don't remember what the exact term they use, but non-citizens who are what you would say illegal, the third biggest group is UK citizens. And the second biggest is US citizens. And that's not who we imagine when people talk about illegal immigration. Mm. So it's people coming in, going to a country on a visa and then staying longer or changing their circumstances or, you know, the relationship they're in breaks down, as well as the things that we see on the news of people sneaking across borders, if you like. So there's lots of different ways of being classed as illegal or irregular, and that's not necessarily counted. But either way, it's a very small percentage of the number of people in the country and the number of people who are migrants in the country as well. Because if you think about who's here, who's not born here, it's a much bigger number who are here totally within the law. So, but the things that we worry about that we're expected to worry about is this kind of law breaking.
The truth is nobody knows.
No. because you can't count something that you can't see. But it is... But we do know that it's smaller than the kind of compared to the population as a whole. It's very small.
Any more questions from the audience? Are you to talk to the government? I mean, the government aware of the research that you're doing?
We tried. there's lots of research on migration and migration control, and we've talked to local government quite a bit, so kind of regional. Offices have been interested getting in touch with Theresa May is harder. So that's some of the people that we interviewed said, go and tell Theresa May. These kinds of things are important too, just for other people.
You don't have one.
Yeah, so this is for both the performers and the audience, really. Working with you guys, I know you guys were very keen to complete the show with asking a question, which I thought was brilliant. I may be biased, but you guys wanted to ask the question that we saw on the slide, which, you know, we're in this situation, where do we go from here? So what I'd like to know from you guys is why that question, or why did you want to leave with a question? And also from the audience, where do we go from here?
You'll never stop migration. It's happened for many, many years and will continue to happen. I think where we go is to try and change the message. The media perceives it or puts it out as a negative message. That gets perpetuated through the press and through social media now, especially spreads the message rapidly. I think that the challenge is to turn that message around and promote it as a positive rather than negative. And when we change minds, then people won't
reflect on it so negatively, and it'll be, once it becomes less of a problem, less of an issue, you know, hopefully then it will kind of just become the norm. It won't be such a talk, it won't be such a media. Yeah, so maybe the answer is to just turn the message on its head.
Can I ask a follow-up to that? Because I think, obviously, also living in a time where there is so much social media, everyone can say something, has an opinion, and there seems to be like we're constantly talking and communicating. But how do we have these kind of conversations? And do you think something like this kind of contributes to a kind of a positive dialogue, no matter sort of talking about this? Is this a way of approaching it? I mean, and you might can say more about this because, like, is there something different to doing a theatre piece, I guess, to reading the newspaper or watching a panel show on TV or, I don't know, other ways that you might be consuming these messages? Like, how do we have the conversation differently, I guess, in order to change the message?
I don't mean to talk again, but the problem is we all follow the path we follow. If you're right-wing, you follow right-wing media, you have right-wing friends on social media, and the message you get is constantly right-wing. If you're further to the left, then you read left-wing press, and you have left-wing social groups. So it's very hard to blur those edges. I think people are moving further apart. And you're very insular. You just look at what you look at rather than a breadth of information from a number of sources.
I mean, putting it across in schools is a good thing, definitely, because obviously these are the generation that you need. They need to sort of learn about, you know, they're growing up with it, so they need to know more about it. And they'd be more intelligent than what we even are, you know, because obviously I knew nothing about this van thing before tonight. So, you know, it just proves that even the negativity isn't always put across. You know, you hear bits, but I knew nothing about this. So definitely, you know, informing the younger generation and bringing it through schools, however they want to learn it, you know, obviously they're taking it in more through drama or performing or whatever, you know, that they make it interesting for them. And I suppose, as they said, you know, showing empathy towards it is definitely, you know, the way forward. But, you know, they're the ones that have got to be taught it. Yeah. It's not always the parents that can teach it either.
I wanted to ask that question because I wanted because I wanted to know what the message was that the
So my view would be, I think all of you individually and together are really powerful, because one of the things that we can change, we may not be able to change the government, some of us may be if we're politicians or involved in that kind of thing, but don't ever think that your voice is too small to change, because the one thing that you have is relationships with other people. And having a relationship with your friends, with other people, your peers in school, even if you notice something and you notice someone who is an immigrant who's going through a lot of turmoil, then you have the power within you to actually challenge that in a way that will help to change things. And if I could just share a little story, some of you may know Tricia Dudu. She's one of our local BBC Coventry and Warwickshire presenters, and she's on every morning from 6 till 9. She's often on the One Show. She's a local girl. And when we first had the Brexit vote, I hate to use that word, she actually encountered someone who'd lived in this country for a very, very long time being verbally abused in the middle of Coventry. And she actually challenged it. And then she was actually faced with racist abuse. Now, she's gone on the One Show. She actually cried because she said she couldn't believe that this is how people that you've acted tonight about, that they were being treated like that. People who'd lived here a very long time, because what she had observed is that these people, this family, were told, well, now we voted, you need to pack your bags and go home. So since then, she's actually campaigned to get young people like you to actually speak up and to actually try and change that. And I think you can do that through relationships. Never underestimate the power that you have as young people, is what I would say.
Absolutely, thank you. Yeah, thank you. Can I ask a question to the actors? So we talked a lot about the stories of people who were
migrants themselves, but you're also talking about the stories of people, the views of people who were worried about migration was in the play as well. I wondered what you thought about that, how you would, is that something you want to talk about more after the play?
I feel like after the production, it's gave us a new thought on what immigration is and Operation Bacon. It gives you a new outlook on this subject, and I feel like this will affect, even with the audience, I think that everyone who watched it or performed in it will at least have a different outlook on it from what they saw before they entered through the doors.
Since I've done this play, immigration has given me like a whole new understanding of what people have been through, and it really interests me now.
So speaking before you performed tonight, and we think it's very important that this message comes across, would you be prepared next week to spread the word a little bit more and perform in front of some of your year group and possibly older?
Yes.
Okay.
Go on,
then. Did we get to miss lessons?
I'll do it every day.
I'll do it.
I think you should be really, really proud of yourselves. Really, really proud. Particularly the mix of you as well. Some of you do GCSE drama, some of you don't. So it's really nice actually that you've come together and you've really formed as a team. We have to thank all of the researchers, Ida, Vanessa as well, for their input, because it's been very beneficial, and I can see your progress as well just from the past 10 weeks. So it's been fantastic. You should be really proud.
Thank you. I was going to ask some final question, but that's such a nice rounding up, so maybe we should just give them all...
Did you have any questions for the audience, though?
Yeah.
Well, look at all these questions.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. You guys go.
I want everyone that's been at this performance to maybe go and tell your friends or someone that about your opinion on what we've just performed, or about how you feel about what we've just been told about what some immigrants wanted to do.
What are your thoughts on the play about immigration?
Thought it was very good. Yeah. Definitely taught us something, that's for sure. Well, it did me anyway. So yeah, very good.
I'm definitely here from my eyes, and I'd like to know how many schools is this going into? Is this just a couple of schools in Coventry, or do you plan to spread it, or team can go to different schools and?
So the project as it is, so we've been working in parallel with this school and one school in Oxford.
Right.
So at the moment, it's in two schools. We have plans with the researchers, now that we've seen how well this works, to take it further, hopefully. Yeah. So hopefully I, come back and maybe do it with another year here, or do it in more schools. It's definitely in the pipeline.
We're hoping for...
Go global.
So, again, with all these things, funding, hopefully we get funding. But it's difficult to get funding, but it's so important to be able to do these kinds of things.
Just a great way to educate.
Yeah,
and the parents.
So we've worked on other projects that are not about the Go Home Man specifically, but other topics around immigration. So we've done projects like this on undocumented migrant children, so young people who come under the age of 18 on their own.
We did one around the refugee crisis in the Calais camp, and also the young people who were stuck there. So.
And we've also worked with young irregular migrants and their family and their access to health care and schooling and that kind of thing. So we've done different kind of areas of migration with different kinds of schools, but...
Maybe get onto YouTube and spreading it onto Facebook. The old positive opinions out.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing, yeah. Our aim is to do that in this way, to kind of start conversations like this. And hopefully everybody here will get, like, said, everybody will hear, will go have a conversation with someone who will have a conversation with someone else. Mm.
I think that was really helpful, like getting around with us.
Really had an opinion, really, to be honest with you. You just know it goes on, and you know, it's like everything, you know, there's good and bad in all, isn't there? Mm. So I can't say I really ever had an opinion. To me, you know, we've all got a part to play in this world, and you know, one of these is live and let live, really. You know, I don't really have an opinion on it, but definitely the way that people are being treated is wrong. I do have an opinion there, you know.
Way to go,
Yeah, it's like for me, and that's it, because I'm Swedish, I'm not British, and you know, so with the whole Brexit thing, it changes things for me as well. So, like, this is always very timely for me personally as well, apart from a professional.
Well, like the chap said at the back there, you know, the, don't look at the positive side of it, you know, that you know, you, I mean, you're here, you come in, you're doing a job, you're teaching the, you know, children the right way of, you know, actually looking at things like this, you know, but that doesn't get aired or viewed, it's always the bad, isn't it? So.
I didn't even know about it until now.
Well, sometime has to be the first, right? So
first for everything.
Yeah.
Right. Well, maybe before we give a final round of applause for actors tonight, I just wanted to remind you that there were some feedback forms on your seats, orange ones for after the performance would be really helpful for us if you could
fill them out.
Now you don't have to do it for me, you can do it for them because they want your opinion. Some of the questions feel really similar, they are, but you're not in Groundhog Day.
Intentional.
There's also a table there for you on that side for you to write any comments, so please do that on your way out. If you are willing to, it would be great if we can get, if anybody's willing to be recorded with Jahan, just a couple of words on what they thought, anything you've said here. Go see Jahan at the back.
So all of your feedback's really useful in terms of getting funding. Yeah. So moving this on, taking it to other schools, doing the US tour. I'm ready for the Arctic.
I'm going to steal these kids just for a couple of more minutes.
Wait. Before I literally burst. Okay. To everyone here watching, hello to you. I just, even though we had an applause for you watching us, we would all like for you to give a massive round of applause for Ida for helping us.
And Vanessa.
And Hannah. I haven't done anything, I just go around giving thumbs to people. Especially for Ida, who's been with us every week. And we, in fact, decided to last minute give her a memorabilia, which was the board of us. And it was awesome. Oh my God.
I'm going to steal them to give them something. So while you're filling out the feedback, these people want